just want you to see that I'm trying. And no, it's not a game. Ain't gonna lose no sleep over what people say.
Just let me live my life. Ah, you ain't giving me my life. Nah, you can't tell me what's right. Ah,
take offense, but I just think it needs to be said. Y'all don't really get the picture. Focus your attention on what really matters instead. Believe it or not, I'm with ya. Don't get too caught up in what you see on the gram. I will stay high for him, cause that's just who I am.
So I don't thank my lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from the Father's heart, not the sky, not chance, but truth is I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Yeah, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Oh, I'm not lucky, I'm loved. I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Yeah, oh, she is. Jesus loves me.
Everything okay? She said, come over here, I got something to say. You shouldn't be on TV acting that way. I said, whoa, you'd rather I be fake. Want me to act like I don't make mistakes? Sorry, ma'am, I ain't cut that way. I gotta keep it 100 all day. And your attitude is worse than mine. And you could be a little bit more fine. And if you want folk to come to your church, we all gotta do some work to be like Jesus.
Be like Jesus.
Like there he is. They wanna remind you of what you did. Don't know why some people just won't forget. And some folk just won't let you live.
Oh, how quick they forget what they did.
Don't even remember who they did it with.
Shh, but that ain't none of my business.
Let me put it just like this. I wanna be like Jesus.
Be like Jesus.
Oh, Hey beauties, happy Monday and welcome to today's episode of Candid, HB's show where we say everything you may be thinking but are too afraid to say. And today I am joined by pastor and gospel powerhouse Dietrich Hayden.
What's up? Hey. Yeah, what's up people? Yeah. We're live, right?
We are live.
What
right
up,
now.
Y'all?
Hey. And today we are talking about, you know, his very public breakup.
Oh, also, help me, Lord.
How
candid are we going to be today?
Oh, we get real candid here.
Because sometimes I can say some things that stir folk up. I want to make sure I'm saying the right things today.
Stir the pot. We got our audience watching, as always, beauties. You know we are taking your questions and your comments and also just weighing in on the conversation. So let's just get it started.
Can I drink my tea?
Oh, you can certainly sip your tea. So you were on the Preachers of L.A. Yeah. So can you talk a little bit about that experience and how you felt about being on reality TV and bringing your personal stuff to television?
It was amazing. I happened to be one of the executive producers of the show along with Lemmy Plummer and Holly Carter. Shout out to y'all. And we did it big. We did Preachers of L.A. We did Detroit. We did Atlanta. It was did very well. Millions of viewers. And I was excited to do it. You know, it was actually one of my idea to do it because I was going through something personally. And I talked to this preacher on the phone. I ain't going to say his name, but he called me and said, Dietrich, you're going through something right now. And I said, yeah, man, I'm going through, man.
Going through it.
Need somebody you need to talk to. Even preachers need somebody they can talk to. Yeah. And I said, man, you think if we put this on a reality show, you think people would be interested? He said, yeah, man. I said, you going to do it with me? He said, no.
He's like, you on your own, man, for that. Yeah. No.
So that's how we did it, and yeah. it was amazing.
Yeah, so let's just talk about what that means, though, when you bring your private life into the public sector. As we know, you had a very public breakup. How did you navigate that now from being in the spotlight?
Well, I think it's a preacher's responsibility to be transparent because there is ministry in transparency. Mm. People want you to keep it real, and you have to realize there are people that are in your congregation and millions of people all over that are going through the same things, or if not worse than what you're going through, and there is ministry that can be extracted out of your test. So I just took the opportunity to share my heart, give people my reality. I mean, you can judge me if you want to, but nobody can take God from me, just like I can't take God from you. No. He's God to you. He's your personal Savior. And I just felt like, man, there are people hurting out there that the church has kind of left behind and judged and said they made their mistakes and it's over for them and that's it, whatever. And it was my responsibility to say, hey, it's not over for you. You can make a comeback. You can make your mistakes because you're human. You can't expect somebody to live 80 years, 90 years on the earth and don't make mistakes. It comes with life, you know? Yeah. And so I thought it was my responsibility to share that with people and connect with people, and it did.
Yeah.
It worked.
Did you feel like, you know, coming forward about the things that happened, did you feel like it made you more accessible, almost like you descend from the pulpit to kind of reach the people?
You got to descend. You got to come from behind the iron wall or the iron curtain, whatever it is that you cover.
The prayer cloth. You got to break the veil.
Right. Come, the inner court's all deep. You got to come out of there and let